y'all. This is the Cypher with KJ and Mal. Yep. Episode 25, all about the paper part 2. Mm-hmm. It's going on in the real way, and this show is sponsored by OG Air Fresheners, man. They got the best air fresheners in the city, man. Go holler at Big Fox at OGFresheners.com.
Yeah, what up, Fox?
And go to Scatter Sites TV and subscribe right here. Hit that button right there, man. Yeah. You catch all our content right there on Spotify, Apple, Deezer, the whole nine yards. Mm-hmm. Right now, man, we about to kick it to my co-host. What on, Mal?
What's up, bro?
Man, chill, you all right? Bro.
Hey. Everybody good?
Man, we good, man.
Yeah, man. Nice out here, man. The rain done went away, so we in here.
Yes, sir, man. You back at the regular location. You know, we've been traveling the last three. You know what I'm saying? So we're back at home, man. And we're going down the real way. And 25, man, we got the, you know, I made the call again.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? And this time last year, you know what I'm saying? A year ago.
Yeah, it had been a year.
It's been a year, man. We did the first All About the Paper, man.
Right.
So, you know, we kept in touch and everything, and, you know, real stuff going on, man, since that time. So we had to touch up, man, and get to talking again, man, because, you know, the streets been talking. You know,
they always talking.
They definitely always talking, man. Going out in a real way, man.
Yeah.
But right now, man, I'm about to introduce to you my homeboy, man, entrepreneur, man, father, husband. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm talking about?
Yeah.
One of the best MCs I know in the city.
Right. Yeah.
Y'all give it up for the City Paper.
City Paper.
Yeah.
Yes, sir. Yeah. What up, brother?
Yeah, what's up? What's up, man? Nice introduction. Happy to be here, of course. You know what I'm saying?
And,
good content. I've been keeping up with a couple. Yeah, for sure, on your way.
I appreciate
y'all still
it, man.
Here in the year, you know what I'm saying? Like, you know what I'm saying? That's good. Yeah. You're doing good.
Yeah, man, I appreciate
since
it.
Since I've been here, so yeah. Keep it up.
Appreciate that, man.
Appreciate that, man. But what's been going on, Paper, since last year, baby? And no, I just want to say, congratulations again, man. You're about to get married on
Yeah, man. That's why I'm a little tired because, like, 3 weeks, and you know, it's crunch time. So, you got to hustle that pack off, man. You know what I'm saying? The real good way. Whatever it is, you got a big old wedding shit going on.
Right.
Crazy, like,
oh man, everybody gonna be there.
Yeah, it's like crazy. Yeah. So you know, the stress in my face is the hustle part of it. But I'm happy.
When the day?
September 11th. Okay. September 9/11. So I call it state of emergency. I made that date. You know what I'm saying? Hey, it's you because you always know I'm marketing or whatever. Want to make it big or whatever. Yeah. So we call it. I did on 9/11.
Yeah.
Call it state of emergency.
Mm.
Yeah.
Yeah. And it's Virgo season.
You're Virgo?
Yes, sir.
Right. My fiance, technically wife, because we already really married.
I got you.
Disclaimer, but she a Virgo too.
Okay.
I know y'all.
Right.
Good people though. Reserve, y'all real reserve, but y'all zero. Y'all get to it.
Yeah.
Y'all get to it.
Yeah, man.
What's
up, bro?
Man, already.
For sure, man.
But man, you know, since I got your back, you know what I'm saying? You know, some of the conversations we had on the last one.
Yeah.
The verses.
Yeah.
LeBron the boy, man. I was watching it, man.
Me too.
I watched it when it was live.
Me too. It was so, man.
I was talking to him, you know.
Yeah.
Let me ask y'all a question.
Yeah.
When I was here, I don't think we had it signed up yet.
No, it hasn't.
But you know, it was a little beef going on.
But I don't think, you know, because it was a spot of the moment. Mm-hmm. And I actually some mutual homies, man, was like, man, you got an attitude problem. You know what I'm saying? I do.
Yeah.
So I understood that, and it was self awareness to say, man, it ain't even really about all that.
Right.
Trying to take it. He said, man, just do it, whatever. So some mutual friends like Lito, Fridge, a couple real ones up high ups, was like, man, just go on and do it, man. Yeah. And then it'd be, and I was just against
it. I mean, it was good for the city
it
for
was,
y'all to do
though.
That, man.
It
y'all
was,
two
though.
Artists coming from the Ville.
It's
so
crazy because I was really mad at home, and then we okay.
Yeah.
It's crazy that
I mean,
I'm a firm believer because I didn't believe in, you know, do this and it'll keep it off. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
So that's I had to be aware.
Well, it also too, man. It also show it. All the verses that's been going on since COVID. It also show other artists, even artists that you have had previous beef with, that y'all can bear the hatchet.
Yeah, it's crazy, man. Because I think we got a whole lot of views. I think a lot of these people, even mainstream people, are seeing it. And I got to attribute a lot of that to Elroy. You know what I'm saying? Like he kind of we did it together,
right?
You know what I'm saying? But there's still like tension though.
Yeah.
Like it was real tension, but we still was online with.
Yeah.
you know, how we was going to do it and prepare it and even make some money and stuff. So we did it together, behind the scenes.
Well, probably a lot of the tension was probably mostly because of Cruz.
Cruz
are going to stay loyal to you. Man, Cruz going to stay loyal to him. Yeah, you got the hottest shit. He has the hottest shit.
And it was the new, it was the new people. I guess since I had been out of it, it was the new fans that I was seeing, which was a lot of his fans, some new people, shit from Facebook and shit like that.
Yeah.
And I was like, damn, so it was a love to stroke my ego. You know what I'm saying? I did it. You know what I'm saying? I'm a Leo. I need the attention. Yeah. So I was like, damn, y'all ain't saying I'm top five. And y'all ain't saying whatever I think I was. So I had to. So I was proud I done it because I let people know, you know what time it was.
Exactly.
You know, man.
Yeah, it was dope, though. Very entertaining, man.
I don't get
Yeah,
boy.
Yeah.
That's a
ooh. Oh, yeah.
That's a,
that's even with Elroy, like, you know, he had a little session with
Elroy.
That was a nice touch, man.
It was crazy. Because I actually told Elroy, worked on that. And me and him had a conversation and stuff after that. He was like, I just didn't think you was going to prepare. You know, everybody think you was just going to be just coming to old paper, just coming. I really prepared. Like, when we signed up to do it, it was like 3 weeks prior. And I worked on it with my family. Got some ideas for some people. Like, should I do this? Even my son, some old people. Like, what should I call? I really fucked with it. Man, weeks straight.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? And he told me, he was like, I didn't really. He did the show and prepared the show to be good. But he didn't really
practice
like I did.
I got
and
you.
I had counters. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. So when he seen, I didn't even do none of my hits early.
Right.
He was like, I was like, I ain't even brought, you know, said, Dope Boy Swag. I'm a hustler. And then when I hit him with all
V12,
I think people didn't understand or remember, you know. And I thought everybody, you think everybody would remember your shit or what you was a part of. People didn't. And people didn't know that Hill I was grind hard first, you know what I'm saying, on the first few. So I used and then when
you talking about Loyalty Records?
And when he came up with the treatment, he was like, yeah, you can use whatever features if you own whatever, and he said just cut it off when you come on.
Gotcha.
You know what I'm saying? Type thing. Yeah. So I looked at it, I was like, God damn. I got Grind Hard 1 and 2with Lito, and then I got Gas 1 and 2 with Buck. That's over. Mm. So I was thinking, like, why would he come up with that?
Right.
So he came up with that. I was like, shit, if I play so I just wrapped it out, like, I'm gonna do Fuck You Mean, Hell You Mean, me and Lito, Grand Hard, and all this old stuff first, 252 grams, all this me and Star stuff.
Yeah.
I was gonna start early then. Yeah. I was gonna go to Gas in the middle, me and Buck, and then I was gonna hit them with my 6 or 7 at the end, you know what I'm saying? So I kind of had my strategy or whatever mapped out.
Man, that's, you got up, your man. You're taking the culture for real.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Not just coming up there, just rhyming and all over the place.
I really prepared. I had my little crew together, had all the bad gals, my wife, and she had like 20 because all of them bad. Like,
and he said that too. He said, well, you brought your crowd with you.
We had the shirts. They had the shirts, but it's like, we had like 18 girls, and it was all teens.
Right.
Or 9 of teens.
Okay.
I'm saying they all the city. It was, and her little crew was more the, you know, she's a little younger than me, like 30, 31. So, so it still was that middle type.
You got culture. 28.
And they the girls that kind of punched the button. So when we seen all them come through, everybody's like, God damn.
So I had
my homies, the real hitters in there. So I had the streets. Yeah, had Wham, had T-High, had all them ones. So I was like, hey, if you ain't got one of them M cases, I said, if you ain't no bad bitch or got a murder case, you can't run with me. So it was like all around, it was like, God damn. So it created the movie and all of this rap shit. But I had to bring it all out, not to lose.
Right.
Oh, yeah, it's competition.
It is competition, man, especially with this hip hop shit. Nothing personal.
And guess what, man? I was out because we bit it a little bit, and I was nervous.
Yeah.
And the reason why I was nervous because homie was so confident. I didn't know if he had one of my baby mamas on tape on the intro. I didn't know what he had. So I was like, because I couldn't believe he was challenging me. Like, I couldn't believe him. And I always, and I tell him to this, I say, bro, I mess with him just from the confidence. He was really, 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 really was. Yeah. When I say he had to run with a name on
that's what I said. I said, man, he got this shit wrong. I said,
he got hard. It was crazy because he was fair. And he asked me, said, City man, you can get this rug. Because he offered me if I paid $1,000 or whatever. Like, he was fucking with it. So he was online with everything. Right. And we talked about everything. We had food and everything. Yeah. So I got the utmost respect, man. And actually, me and him then chopped it up and actually done seen each other out of town. And actually been online since then. It's crazy. Yeah. It's crazy. So
not only he was trying to big you up. He was big himself.
Yeah, he was.
And he was trying to bring more and energy to both of y'all. And that's what it's about, man. You know what I'm saying?
He definitely did that. I was mad. But even with this, you know, I even went and recorded the record. I recorded the record about him. And that was the last song. I knew he was going to do the couple songs he had about me and stuff. Yeah. But I don't think he was waiting. I'm like, and the rules were you had to have something. It had to be out.
Okay.
Right? So I already recorded and put it on Apple Music. Nobody been checking for my music, so it was already uploaded and everything. So
the one you dropped after the
So I was like, so it was a song about Era, so I was like, and for the finality, and I said, and it's out. Go to Apple Music, so it's out. So it was with the crew. So it's kind of like, nobody didn't know because nobody had been checking for my music, right? I had it already uploaded. It's just so, dude, man.
I got to show you got respect for the game.
Yeah.
You got respect for your craft.
And you
actually played by the rules, recorded a song, uploaded, so he couldn't come back and say, hey,
that wasn't.
You know what I'm saying? That's strategy.
Shout out to Bamplay. Bamplay getting a hot record. We went to the studio. Man, listen, bro brought me out to go to the studio to practice every day. I'm going over shooting my kids and shit. Like, I meant that.
Yeah.
So he brought all that up out of me, man. But after that, it was good. It was all I really didn't revisit. But I did have a little inkling of momentum. Not even momentum. I had momentum, but just energy to kind of keep it going, but it only lasted like 2 or 3 days, man. And I was back.
Did you feel like this was one of the shows that you probably had? You felt like you prepared the most. Like
I did.
Was you know what I'm saying?
That was if I go look back at my career, I never really. Man, I was just in the moment, man. I was just getting on, man. So, so even with that, when you talk about that that verse the other day with Jada Kiss and shit, them Dipset niggas remind me a lot of me because I just went and just rocked out. You know what I'm saying? With my niggas and everybody knew my shit.
Right.
It wasn't really the hip hop art, and that's what kind of era was trying to go. Niggas, the hip hop and it's the art.
So you had
two different people. Right. You had like all these rappers, and I respect them.
Mm-hmm.
The Beehives, the Elroys, the Foo Stays, all of them was there, and it was kind of like, and that was the only ones. And I'm going to say it, they was like, man, but what I said, man, it wasn't even close, man. That shit 19-1. That 19, shit 18-2. If that. But all the rap dudes was kind of making it like he had 5. But listen, the scorecard, he might have got 2 or 3, but it was unanimous. He said that. He was like, bro, you just.
Because was y'all just going off the crowd? Or
And that was our bet. We was just like. We gonna do it, put it online, and let kind of the people judge. But he already, before we even left, was like, bro, man, here's what I got for you, whatever. Man, you he already knew.
Exactly.
He already knew. But when the people was walking out on my last one, and he was still up, he already knew. He was like, man, this shit different.
It's
you know what I'm saying? He gave it to me, though. Man, I fuck with him, though.
It was dope.
It was dope, man. I watched it for me.
It was dope.
When you dropped the mic, man, just walked up, I said, oh, shit, this nigga.
One moment, I was I was like, shit, I'm at the red light. You cut it off real quick.
It's like the crown, though.
I think we said like 40 people, special invited guests could come or whatever, but it ended up being like 150 people in there. So we had a mini little thing in there. And it was the who's of the who's, man.
For those that didn't watch it, what did y'all film and shoot it at the whole of that? What was y'all?
It was like a studio right there off behind the sound station stadium. But I've been there before, but it was a studio and more like a performance type studio.
Like a
sound
stage.
Something like sound stage. Yeah. Something like that.
It was
something
nice,
like
man.
It was nice.
Yeah, dog.
I had a lady, man.
Yeah. It looked real professional.
We had the food for everybody. Yeah. Man. You get the ticket, 2 drinks, man, and we bought all the drinks and shit like that.
Right.
For everybody, then we got the overs, you know what I'm saying?
Fluid was out there.
Fluid actually helped kind of push it forward. And, you know, he was kind of
the mitigator and the mediator.
Right.
And there's a lot of people that was mediating, you know, for it to happen all the way, because I was a little high-headed, like, man, I ain't. Yeah. But, man, once I signed on, I think I was drunk one day in Miami, and Freeze called me, and I was, I was in Miami, and I was listening to my shit.
Yeah.
And I was, what I was listening to? I was listening to Down in Miami, Bad Bitch, so switching up my house or something. Yeah. And then somebody was like, man, bro, you just need to do blah, blah, blah. And, man, I end up calling Freeze, and Freeze is our mutual homeboy. Freeze cool with him, Freeze cool with me. Mm-hmm. Freeze put it together. Freeze was like, man, bro, here's the rule. And I did it there. I was like, man, I'm ready to go. I'm ready, man. You know, feeling myself. Because sometimes I listen to my music and just feel those goosebumps and stuff. I'm a big fan of my own music. I go somewhere, and that's enough of the accolades I need. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Sometimes
you have to be.
Yeah, I'm like, damn, I was rough.
Because if you don't think you the shit, ain't nobody else gonna think. You know what I'm saying?
It ain't nothing.
For sure, man.
Yeah.
See, on that note, you ever did ever wanted to come out with another tape?
Yeah, after that, I actually was working on something. I get like one or two songs after I did the verses, man. And it took literally like 5 days, man. And I thought it would kind of come back, and it just didn't, man. And I'm just like, man, I don't know what it is. Yeah. I don't know if it's, I don't know if I ain't tapped in enough. Like, what I mean by tapped in enough, like, my music was just active. I was more active, you know, participating, right? And now I can do it from the outside looking in type, but I don't have enough substance and enough content, you know, from the way I like to do it, you know, first person. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. So I don't feel it enough. Like, I don't even feel my, you know what I'm saying? It was cool, but it was too much of this and this and this and that. Oh, and I just ain't with all that shit no more. Like, I ain't even with, you know, we done this and we done this and yeah, we'll do this. And I just, you know, when I'm looking at them kids every day, it gets me that split. If I could do it from a standpoint where it wouldn't make me just feel like, I almost look at myself like I'm corny when I talk about that. At this point in my life.
Yeah.
Like, it's like, I'm telling what I'm gonna do. I mean, that one day it was good, and I said that, like I said, when I even said that comment, like, when I think about that, I'm like, bro, that shit corny. So I'm self-aware to the point of this thing. Now, if I had some other stuff and I was a conscious type rapper and read every day, and I do know some of that stuff, but I don't have enough of it to come out with a product.
And I think that's what copies, I mean, because, you know, we older and the game's done changed. Like, music done changed. Mm-hmm. You know, one minute you into it, you're like, damn, this shit hard. Then the next day, it's like, I look kind of corny doing this shit.
I don't want to do this shit.
You see what I'm saying? So I think that's music. Man, you know what I mean? It's up and down.
That's
man.
Definitely what it was. So I took the ladder and said, man, I'm gonna go chill. And I'm gonna do what I'm doing.
Right. That's what's up, man.
Man, with this music. And we're talking about the father part, man. I've seen you with your son.
Yeah, speaking of that, so my son kinda he do music, but my son kinda like a Uzi fan.
Okay.
He like a Uzi Playboy Cardi. I don't even know them dudes, but he put me on these dudes. Yeah. He like a dancer type, singing type type dude. He do some, but he don't like represent the streets or nothing. Nah. Man. He's a street dude, be a fun dude. Yeah. So he love to dance. He got like a YouTube channel. He like go and do he like, we want to do backup dance and shit, like hip-hop dancing, but on the street side.
On the street shit,
you know what I'm saying? He come through on your ass, you know what I'm saying? Real street.
Right.
In his blood, you know what I'm saying? Ain't looking funny or nothing, you know what I'm saying? But that's his element, almost fun stuff. So I actually was helping him do some music and kind of getting him some beats and kind of just helping him on his off time.
Yeah.
And with his dance stuff and his blog stuff and his music stuff. So that, I was kind of doing that. And when I was kind of doing that, Sean God had been helping me do that with him. And that's kind of what I was focusing on, you know what I'm saying? Because that's kind of therapeutic to him when he not playing ball.
Right.
So he was like, man, when I ain't playing ball, I'm going to do this Dame Little type shit.
Mm-hmm.
But he said he don't want to separate music and ball. You know, when he was doing his rap and singing thing, he talking about get 30 on you.
Right. Mm-hmm.
So he ain't really like, I'm not a basketball, if it makes sense.
And
like Shaq back in the day.
For Shaq only.
Bam, sorry, I'm talking about
it. And
that's why I worked with Shaq.
Yeah.
Even though we might not have thought it was the best music, Shaq was probably the only one that it really worked, because everybody was like, he ain't really trying to be nothing else.
No.
That song that Phil was my father, whatever. that was a big record. Even that other one.
Even the one, can't stop the rain with
it. Right. It was his true self. Yeah. That makes sense. So that's, that remind me a lot of what Lamarck is trying to do or whatever. It's like his true self. It's all him or whatever.
Yeah.
That's why I'm gonna go ahead.
I can tell, like, with the new generation now, it's like they are getting back to that, you know, dance, feel good party atmosphere music. It ain't to shoot them up, bang, bang, selling dope, whoop, 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 whoop. Yeah. These kids want to just have fun.
That's it, though. Yeah. That's it, though.
They just want to have fun.
These folks looking, oh, they weird. No, man, they're up there having dancing. Yeah. Having fun.
Exactly.
I had an issue. It wasn't really an issue, but a guy kind of attacked because, you know,
I was going to get on that.
Oh, yeah.
So you say, go ahead.
Yeah,
that's what I'm getting up to.
That's
what I'm saying. You know.
Yeah,
you gonna take the words out of my mouth.
Yeah, all right. Yeah.
But I want to get to that. So it was like, you know, cause you know the guys and NCAA is, you know, can get, you know, signed, you know, in
So
I feel like, okay, this man's son was balling, and you know, as a freshman.
Yeah.
Right. So it's like, okay, they letting the chains out there.
Yeah.
So me knowing paper, he
you was right in my alley.
So they own him. So I'm like, okay. So I'm online.
Yeah.
Oh, man.
Right. Yeah,
who's up to 50,000 streams?
Yeah.
Your son.
Yeah.
Then we get a, you know, I'm hyped. I'm like, oh, man, the city going to be roaring.
Yeah.
You know, they got Hershey down here now.
Yeah.
So, you know, we, you know, I see a little comment, you know, oh, man,
yeah,
he got a song out now, man.
Yeah, man.
You know what I'm saying? I'm like, man, oh, man, we that's Nashville.
Yeah.
But it brought me back, man, we need to stop that, y'all. And plus, a grown man doing
here's
that.
What here's my take on it.
I got you.
Here's what I take on it. I'm glad I got this platform to kind of say it because I don't really argue really well. Here's my take on it. Like, let's get this one thing. Everybody can have an opinion. I understand that. Like,
yeah.
Boom.
Yeah.
All right, that's cool, all that. But I vibrate real high, right?
Right.
Here's what I'm saying. Opinion is this. Opinion is, you know, what happened was my son's song got on the radio.
Mm-hmm.
You know, probably from my connections, whatever, because a lot of people want to be on radio. So, I hear, you know, those are white up first hand, boom, we got interviews. So, all of that energy is from me being a good dude.
I'm ready.
So, he got a song playing on the radio. It was crazy. So, it was playing like 2 weeks. So, the third day was his birthday or whatever. We pumping it up, and he proud, and it's just great.
Yeah.
When you like it, you don't, whatever, whatever. Boom, it ain't, you know what I'm saying, but it's good. It's good energy. He going.
Yeah. So, I'm thinking niggas mad because it's his birthday.
All of that energy. All of that energy. He on Kenny Smooth, he on this, you know what I'm saying? You know, pulling out all my strings.
He'll
be on here next, you know what I'm saying? So, but I did it in a succession where it looked like it was a lot of energy. You know what I'm saying? I made it. It was like, damn, he going on his tour, interview tour. So, boom.
Mm-hmm.
Long story short, man, so I get online and see one comment, dude. It was like, oh, he a rapper now, blah, blah, blah. But I didn't even see that one. And then it was two. He did two.
Yeah, it was.
And then he was like, I can't wait to hear when it drop. And I was all of this stuff. So I looked at it, I was like, damn. So I put it all together because I'm like, damn.
Why create this kettle? This
I was so confused. So I asked him, I was like, what are you talking about, homie? Because, man, dude never had no problem. You know what I'm saying? He played for my pops, my mama represented him, and all of this stuff. Supposed to be family, boom. So I asked him, who you talking about? He's like, your son, nigga. First thing I say, your mama, you know, whatever. I don't care who dead in your family piss off. You know, I go all the way.
But
it wasn't even a back and forth. Actually, Facebook started taking my stuff down. I said, I hope your grandmama dead and woo woo woo. And everybody, here's my thing. Like, why would you attack? And not even that he a kid. Like he is 20. Just whatever it is, but like, it's good energy. Our job as friends, so when I said to people, you know, I talked shit to my boy Odell. He was like, in the middle, he was like, what'd he say? I'm like, man, 9 out of 10 people knew that was out of pocket. Everybody was attacking dude.
Sure. Exactly.
Why would you even condone somebody that's, you know, not saying that you can have an opinion. Hell, I have an opinion about my son, right? I have an opinion about a lot of people, but if they're a good kid and they try to do stuff the right way and off the street, our job to me, you know what I'm saying, is to protect their mental, their confidence, whatever it is, right? Because it's just something to be honest, my son seen it first. Somebody, he not on Facebook, but a lady sent it to him, a lady, he talked to the lady daughter, and she was like, damn, they already hating on you. Well, my son was the one, like, he like me, y'all old dudes crazy, man. He got the... my son got the utmost confidence. People don't know. Right. He always said he ain't worried about nothing these dudes doing, but I and his family and everybody took it personal. So me had a little back and forth here and there, man. But it, but shout out to Cashville because Cashville attacked him. Cashville was like, man, you out of pocket, you wrong. You not you 50, 45, whatever. You're not supposed to like a 19-year-old son.
Right.
So if you do, you might go, man. It's
with
cool
the music and everybody.
Yeah, like, bro, you're a hater. And it went back to 2 weeks that you saying it's Hershey's house, whatever, trying to create division. Something wrong with dude. And I told dude, you were the weakest dudes, and I said, I'm not even going to give him that platform to say his name, but he's one of the weakest, most terriblest dudes walking around. And I told him. And me and my brother told him, like, when we see you, we're going to say something to you. He know that. He know that. And I told him, I was like, he's like, oh, yeah. And like I said, man, so me and my brother, but we both, like, we know you do. You do this over kids, you're wrong.
You're
terrible, you're the problem that we try to get out of hand. And then he my son. It's every other day. Oh, so-and-so, he talk about Barry on all Wizards Grace. Like, you're just a bad person, man.
Yeah.
You're a bad person.
Or you don't like your life.
No, that's what I'm saying. You're miserable. And it makes you, I was a bad person. Who wasn't, this time it wasn't no big old, I wasn't even, I said what I said and I meant it. And I mean, when I see him, I'm going to talk, he's scared of me.
He know
when I see him. I'm telling him, I'm going to come see you. Come see you. And it ain't got to be all like, because you out of pocket and we got to get these people out of the way because these are the people that, what if my son went over there and you feel this type of way and he went and talked to your team or he went, it's so many people acting like they're community active, but they're really bad people. They really don't like you. You're waiting for your son or daughter. It might be your daughter that they'll hit. It might be your son to give him a pack. That's the same spirit.
That's the same spirit of
dudes. Like, so I put it out there to expose them. Like, it's bad people. Man, I won't even get, if I see somebody's son, that's all, you got an obligation to me and I got an obligation to you. If me and you say that we friends or we cordial on that, I'm not going to get on nothing. Your daughter might sing, do kickball or kickboxing or sing and recite. She might have a bad day. You're a little popular, right?
Yeah.
It's my obligation as your friend or somebody to shake your hand to not hurt that child's confidence or anything else. That's what I say. Exactly. I don't give a fuck about no opinion. Yeah. All the people that say, oh, it's an opinion, I look at them like they're weird. I tell Odin, it's my obligation, if you my friend, to say that's wrong because we got to protect what good that we have in us.
Exactly.
You know what I'm saying?
Right.
I'm not finna shake your hand. Your daughter can sing the national anthem. You think I'm going to be the one, even if she done wrong, even if it's bad.
Yeah.
Right? She a good person. I get on there and say 2-3. Come on, y'all. I pray too high for that.
Right.
I pray way too high for people to say, oh, you got an opinion. Whoever say that, I think they're wrong. Whoever condone that type of behavior, I think they're wrong. Out of here.
Yeah, right.
Yeah.
That's my opinion.
That's what I'm saying.
There's too much in the middle stuff. Like, if we're protecting these kids, man, you know, I don't really say much about anybody that's young adults, anybody. Yeah. I don't have an opinion on a lot. You know, I'm not like a social media opinion. I'm not really like that.
Real opinionated.
Yeah, but if somebody, like I said, it's local. This somebody, child, this somebody you can touch. And you make not one comment, but two comments. Then you try to throw error in it. What error had to be? Error okay.
Exactly.
So what if it would have went that way? Me and error okay. I can't wait for error to. So you done made a comment about my son and put error in it. You all the way
out of pocket.
And then we trying to have the city win.
Man, he ain't wrong, man. So, homie, I think you're the worst dude in the world, and I'm going to talk to you.
Just stay coming back the way they are, man.
Man,
you know,
so
we got
much.
Hershey down here.
Yeah, so much, man. So when I was here, it wasn't
none of that.
It's crazy.
But
still,
you were talking about your son.
And we were still talking about energy. We were still, y'all was appreciated enough to
man,
to talk about that energy and what they was trying to create. Mm-hmm. That right there with Master P and Hershey, actually, my son, shit, I posted a picture about, they must have been in sixth grade, it must have been 7-8 years ago, but we got Master P down here. So basically, here's how it started. So they used to play AAU.
Mm-hmm.
So Master P had a team out of California. Silk the Shocker had a team. Silk's son good, too.
Mm-hmm. Okay. I seen
his son a year younger, but his son can play. Yeah. So all of these people, so we big in, and that's why I tell people, this sports shit, we been so big in, and now people kind of seeing the fruits of the labor, but, you know, we got a team. So our team is Marcus, and he playing this is a small team, but you got Darius Garland on that team. You got Marvin Bagley, I'm sorry.
Mm-hmm.
You got Keon Johnson that just went to the league. James Springer that just went to the league.
Right.
All these people play on my son's AAU team.
Yeah.
So people don't know it's from kids.
And which Keon is from Shelbyville, which is close to Lewisburg, my hometown.
Okay,
so I know him and his family.
That's crazy. So, so Keon Marcus, Jaden Springer, Marvin Bagley, Darius Garland, all of these people play AU. So we've been had all these people on the team. So we're playing nationally. So I'm posting shit all the time. But people, it's like 2012. You know, people not really ever really on like fifth grade.
Yeah.
But
yeah.
we come across Master P. Now Master P got a team. He got them hitters on. Yes, Jalen Suggs on his team.
Oh, okay.
So Jalen Suggs is point guard. So my son and Jalen Suggs, same class, been playing against each other since second grade. Right? Friends. So if you look at my son, comments and stuff, you got Suggs, you got Moses Moody. All these people follow him and comment. They friends. Yeah. All these people in the same class. Yeah. So you got Master P, got the team Suggs. Suggs, the point guard. Hershey is the two guard. They about the same age. I think Hershey reclassed. I think he put him back. But they about the same age. We playing against these dudes. So we get Master P to come to Pearl Cone.
Okay.
Master P, so I posted a couple pictures where I was telling him.
I seen that.
Everybody, we are bringing Master P team to Pearl Cone. They're in fifth grade.
Yeah.
They're in fifth grade. Yeah. So, boom. We played them, we beat them. It was a big fight at Pearl too. Some fans got to fighting, but Master P ran out the back, so my dad let him out the back. We all just
right, 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 right,
right. Yes, yeah, but right. fast forward, man, they remain friends. And me and P remain, you know, friends, just knowing each other from basketball dads.
Yeah.
It wasn't no, he don't know I do music or nothing. Because of my team that won, and we always played for the national championship 1 and 2. So Jalen Suggs being the number one player in the country.
Mm-hmm.
On that same list, you got Sharif Cooper, number 8, Marcus probably number 9. So he always in Hershey on there. So they always been playing and going to camps together.
Mm-hmm.
So when Master P was pushing the HBCU thing, whatever. Hershey first thing was to reach out with Marcus, like, what is a Tennessee State? Because people already follow Lamarcus because he kind of got some followers and he was turned up last year.
Right.
So Hershey was like, boom. So he checked on him, and Marcus was the one kind of recruiting him or whatever. And it came to fruition. He was like, man, I think I'm going to make my own route, go to HBCU way. My daddy already got money. You know what I'm saying? So it's like, boom, I don't need the, you know what I'm saying? Master P really pushed that education shit to the point where, man, they, you know what I'm saying? So anyway, man. Hershey hit him up, man, and Marcus was recruiting him and shit.
Yeah.
He told me, like, he said, man, I think Hershey's gonna commit. Yeah, like, for real? Because, you know what I'm saying? He's like,
yeah.
Like, we really can't say nothing. But when he did it, you know what I'm saying? Master P started pushing that line or whatever. Mm-hmm. They made whatever I'm doing magnified even more.
Right.
So I was happy. Like, so when Homer was trying to create that division, I'm like, no, everything that Master P do put the light on what I'm doing.
Yeah. Exactly.
Yeah, because Marcus is the leading scorer. He averaged 13 and a half last year's a freshman.
Yeah.
So he's the leading scorer coming back. So he already
in the whole conference.
Yeah,
he tapped in already.
So he should be first team preseason, all that. So he did what somewhere saved him. He did whatever. So I'll say you can't discredit whatever he done as a freshman.
Mm.
Had 230 nights and 720 nights as a baby. So you already, so he don't gotta really do nothing. So that's why he embraced Hurst and we embraced P. So when dudes like whatever, I mean, it's weird. Our energy, man, just being 30-something thousand followers, but it's all Nashville. P got the national thing, and we mixing that in. And then they hit in Georgia and the football then.
Right.
And they trying to get COVID to unleash it. And if that happened, you got the homecoming. That's the prequel to basketball. They actually playing their first game on homecoming weekend. Homecoming week. So that Thursday, Tennessee State play their first exhibition or home game. You know what I'm saying? I think against some scrub team, but it's going to be crazy.
Homecoming.
Thursday, I think they playing, so it's crazy how
that's when they do their midnight madness.
So all of that just lining up. Master P got all this different. They got 2 ESPN games, 1 black college game is going to be on ESPN2. I think they play Wisconsin on ESPN2. So they got their shot, and Marcus got his shot. You know what I'm saying? Not even to put pressure on him, just it might be this year, next year, whatever, but if they can get to the dance and do whatever he need to do,
you got a shot.
That's what's up, man.
I love that.
I'm most definitely going to be tuned in.
Yeah, it's going to be crazy.
For sure, bro.
I'm like, dude, that's Aurora City. Nigga.
Yeah.
Shaking for real.
I know it's going to be crazy. We'll probably need to act of Congress to get tickets to get
them. Yeah, man. They redone the court. They got the big Jumbotron.
Okay.
Some entertainment stuff every game to make it less more,
interactive.
Just doing stuff with the community. You know what I'm saying? So it's going to be crazy, though.
That's what's
I'm excited,
up,
man.
I love it, man.
Yeah.
I really love it, man. And I want to speak on this too, Paper Man. Which I want to give a shout out, man. One of the legendary coaches, man, Maurice Fisher, your dad, from his retirement, man.
Yeah, man. That happened too.
Right. You know, so what you think about that,
yeah,
man?
Yeah, that happened too. I think he should have retired a few years ago.
Yeah.
You think he just went back home two more years?
He wanted to get that job. Oh, I wish he could have had a couple more years there, but he's just old, man. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Like 65, and it just, the game has just evolved so much, and he's still stuck with them old
plays.
Man, he going to run
that power.
3rd and 80, give the virus.
Yeah, right.
So he's terrible. I kind of want it. I think he stayed a little too long, but I think he got his man, whoever he wanted in, you know, ushered in. He had somebody under him. He was making sure he got the job. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? When it's somebody he was tight with, a younger coach and stuff like that. But I was proud, though. I think, you know, of course I'm always going to be biased, but I think he needs a statue in front of Pearl Cone. I ain't never seen nobody that done two state championships in
Metro.
Yeah, Metro. Oh, and they need, like, not even a field or something. Like, I'm big on that.
Call a couple Fitzgerald Field. They need a couple.
Yeah, like, so I said that a few years ago, and everybody gave me a hard time. Like, nah, I'm just saying. Everybody was just like, you know, when I say it, yeah, I look back on stuff. I do look back on stuff. I say stuff a little. I be my probably drunk or something. I do say it a little too hard. And I'm like, you know what I'm saying? So I'm learning that now. Like, but I was seeing, you know, when my son came to Stratford, I think they did the they did the court of Charlie Anderson, whoever. I think he coached Aquinas and he coached some white men. Aquinas and coached Stratford. They gave him the court. Then you went to Doc Shelton. They gave him the court in Martin Luther King. Then you go to Hunter's Lane. Pig got the field, right?
Really?
Yeah. So all this shit was going on, and I was a little envious. I was a little like, damn, Pops, that's a big dog. And I just didn't think nobody rap. You know what I'm saying?
And your baby got two rings.
Yeah, two rings.
Yeah.
So, like I said, hopefully I think they're good enough this year to get a ring.
Yeah.
And maybe they get two. Maybe they get three. You know what I'm saying? And I'm probably in the brunette to get it or fit whatever, because my dad told me, he's just so humble, man. He's just like, man, whatever. I'm a big dog. He know.
Yeah.
I'm just more of his son than I just seen it. And I just, you know, and then he do. Now, don't get me wrong. My dude got all the respect in the world. And even when it comes to my son, you know, a lot of people like, man, everybody loved Lamarcus. You know what I'm saying? There was one dude. That's why everybody got on him. Yeah. Everybody loved my dad. They kind of, synonymous. They like the same.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Those two. You know, me and my brother look, you know, on this end. Uh-huh. Right? For whatever reason.
I mean,
I know the reason, but it's just, but them two are good guys, you know? So my son, I want him to kind of follow that path of my day. Diplomatic. He ain't really.
Right.
And that's why I get on people's head about him, because there are a lot of people that just going to stay out the way.
Yeah.
Ain't going to be in nothing.
Right.
You got to protect those people.
No, you have to, man.
I'm like, come on,
you have
to.
You
can be out here being a fool, man. Come on, bro. You going to do that.
Man, your son is just the plus plus.
That's the plus.
You're gonna protect him. You know
that's
what I'm saying?
Plus plus. So I think those people that you know, everybody got, they just like my pop, man. You know what I'm saying? You gotta say something about him in the private. Because it's gonna be somebody, even if he was hard on him, you know what I'm saying? Some people he'll tell you he might didn't coach the right way. Or sometimes he was young, may tell me stories all the time that, you know, man, I was 30 something, almost 40. He said I was 40 when I won a state championship. So imagine 3-4 years before that. I'm 35, 36 years old, so I had to learn.
Yeah.
You see what I'm saying? Yeah. I look at it like it.
Right.
The state championship was 96. My pop's
6'5",
6'5". He probably was 40, you know what I mean? So he 30-something when he coaching y'all.
Yeah.
When he throwing people out the ride, he's a nut. So he said, man, I had to learn and evolve. So a lot of things I didn't do right. A lot of people I didn't coach right, but I treated people with respect, and I loved them, right? Mm-hmm. So that's it. Yeah, it can come to, you know what I'm saying? But if people deliberately don't treat you with respect and love you, you know what I'm saying? You know he loves you. So that's why at the end of the day, you're like, man, I could have started over him, or maybe he had me at the wrong position, or maybe all of that could be true.
It could be true.
And I never argue with that, because I'm at games and looking at him like, come on, man, what you doing? Running 3rd and 12, you running that old draw. You used to run with Kevin now, man.
So
a lot of stuff you can, but when it comes to being real and respect, like, you gotta, you know what I'm saying, you gotta separate that.
For sure.
That's what
For sure.
much respect, man.
Yeah, man.
Everybody, the whole.
Well, congratulations on his retirement, man.
Yes, sir.
Let him chill. Yeah, man.
I love you, man. You gave me the starting job when I was 14.
Yeah, you look good, though, Kevin. I remember that. You look good. You came in ready.
Man. You don't have to talk about it.
You came in ready. It was just, let's talk about that. You were so before your time. I think I didn't know about football like that then. And still don't know about it like right now. But you coming in is big. Mm-hmm. They listen to my daddy talk about it. Mm-hmm. You was one of them that he wish he could get back and he wish he could have did it because he was one of them. You was one of them that he said that was one of them pros. See, it was people like my brother and them that just worked real hard. And he went as far as he could to be that cornerback, a backup cornerback, 4 years. That was the most in SEC.
Mm-hmm.
But that was the most. He just maximized his ability. But then there's somebody like you that didn't from whatever reason. Like my dad said, some people that had way more talent. That's what I'm saying.
That's what we're talking about with Dante.
Yeah. Got way more talent than my brother.
I got you.
Mm-hmm. Raymond Rose had the ability. For real though, my pop said it all the time. Like some people just
because he was telling me a story about the trap. When you're talking to the kids, you're like, man, I had a couple rides with no woman except Kevin Johnson's mama. I said, Kevin, you told me this at the corner bar.
I said,
for real? And now this is in
2000
or so.
3 years ago, four years ago.
And this was in 92 when this man came on my mama house.
He said it's the only one that heard him when he left and that he begged to come.
Yeah.
You know, sometimes he was even back then, he was a big dog to say, he did his way to beg you to come, but if he didn't, it wouldn't be no ill will. But Kevin was one of them.
He
probably was too. He said, I should have begged him more and was too.
Today, one thing, you'd be like, okay, man, if I could change that, that'd be the one. I would never left Pearl High School.
You know
what I'm saying? But at the same time, as a 14-year-old young man,
facts.
I never had a man talk to me that way. I'm serious.
I got you.
So if you think about it, it's my mama all the time.
Yeah.
My uncle's really ain't
My
brother, that's my brother.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? But man just talking, big sorry. Man, I'm going to White Creek. Man, I don't got to take this. But he said that.
Right.
He said he should have. That was the one, and he learned over time.
Yeah.
He said because that it always haunted him. He said that's the one he got away from. Yeah. And that's when he learned. Now he tell people how to talk to people. Right. You got to pick the ones. He said he had so much talent, and he actually learned.
So he was like, "Damn, why did I talk?"
Big John came years after you. He almost lost Big John to basketball. Big John didn't want to play football anymore. He quit.
My John Henderson.
Yeah, he quit. Coming his junior year, his side played freshman and sophomore year. His junior year, he quit.
Yeah,
Him and Ron Slate quit together. So they both in the office. Yeah, so you remember. So Ron a year younger, but
shout out to Ron, man.
John and Ron walked in the office and they was going to have this speech to tell my daddy that they quit. Yeah. Well, he looked at Ron and said, get your ass on out of here. he looked at Big John like, shit, where you going? So he stand off, and Big John went on there and put on his pads. You know?
But he actually didn't play. He didn't play the first three games, so he quit. He quit, or it was acting like he was hurt. Some kind of way, he didn't play the first three games, and Pearl lost. So that year that they lost those games and they won the state championship, Big John wasn't playing. He had quit. Uh-huh. He came back to the team, and they ran the team.
It was a big Ricky, man. Shout out to man. I love you, Big Ricky. He was on that team.
Big Rick was over RP. Man, that's crazy. That happened. Yeah, Big Rick. So they end up running the table. But back to the point, he was saying you learn over time, you know.
Right. Yeah.
Different personalities, different circumstances, you know, and KJ was one of them.
Yeah.
He said, he could have been a pro.
One of those stories, man. I love it. But we're still here, man.
Right.
But I just want to speak on two paper, you know, it was about the music and everything. And you know, we was in the hood, nigga, you know, we was in the alley. Shout out to PJ and Charlie, man. PJ and Rat, you know, Trav, everybody, man. Yeah. Everybody came through that day, man. You know, see how that Charlie since he been out?
Yeah, I talked to Charlie a few times since he been out or whatever.
And
actually hung out with him and met with him and done some stuff. And I used to see y'all on interview in the alley. You know, the alley right there. So that's where my son stayed. That's his alley.
Okay. Mm.
So yeah, he got a nice tattoo and it said like
Yeah, so that's his mama right there. So you got Charlie and them, their first cousin. So Charlie's mom's right there. And next door where y'all was at is Marcus' mom. Okay. And granny stay right there. So, but yeah, he was actually out there in the house. He was saying Charlie knew was doing a podcast, and I knew it was y'all. So it's a small world. But yeah, man, like I told you off camera,
dude did 18 years, and I like how he came out. He still got his mind and stuff. It's still smooth. So I'm actually support the movement, whatever. Yeah, I ain't really tapped into getting on it or nothing like that. But y'all support him, and yeah, I think he got a record coming out or a project.
Yeah, man, I think it's more money, more problems.
Yeah. So I'm see how I do, and it's a lot of little nuances that I try to help him with. And he asked me for advice of, you know what I'm saying, what's going on and this and this, and actually told him it was a good thing when y'all was reaching out or whatever, because y'all kind of alluded to it when I was here earlier. So that's good. And it's good to give him a platform and, you know, let him be a rapper and stuff like that, man, because I think it's fun. I think he need that and enjoy that.
For sure. For sure, man.
Yes, I love it, man.
Because man.
Keep it all the way rolling.
He made us honorary members that night.
Charlie, he got a lot of respect, man. He's a good dude. Charlie, a real one. Fuck with him.
For sure.
Yeah, man, because we're going to be out there with them October 16th, man. We're doing another part, too.
See how that's going.
They're going to drop there. They're dropping the album, man, so we're going to catch the other ones, you know what I'm saying?
That's
what's up, man. Man, I got a question to ask you, Piper. You know, we'll call it a day. State of hip hop today, what you think on it, man? Because, you know, it's like you really can't say nothing anymore, you know what I'm saying? Like the baby getting fucked up and. You can't say this, you can't say that.
Crazy.
You know what I'm saying? And everything's getting, you know, ultra sensitive now, man. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, back, you was rapping, nigga. It was, Cutthroat City, man. But now it's just like, you know, you got the cancel music, you know what I'm saying? The cancel movement. Right. And,
man, I just think
you can't speak your mind no more.
Yeah, it's weird, man. It's definitely weird. You gotta know, you gotta play in the middle and gotta be, I guess, diplomatic. But the true art for music is just saying whatever comes out. That's the true art, and that's why people respect it. You know, the music. You know, just like I alluded to earlier, when you know, I'm like, man, I don't really feel it no more because I, you know, it's conflicting in my spirit for what I can say, what I can't say, what I'm doing, what I'm not. Yeah. So when you in the moment and saying stuff or whatever, that's when you really, you know what I mean? And that's when, whatever, right or wrong, you know what I mean? That's why Pac was good. That's why all these people were good because you like, damn, they said that, whatever, but you know it's true to them. If it makes sense. And you know you had to go back on it and explain and have a move and stuff. So I just think, you know, the state of hip hop now, they gotta kinda watch that and you know, if I'm getting money like that, I mean, you know, a lot of people say it's a sellout, but I probably bring it down some. You know what I'm saying? It's sad that you gotta do that, but I mean,
the whole thing, man, you got skinny jeans on trying to put $40,000 in it. Somebody take it. Somebody take it, man. You know what I'm saying? Because you think about it, paper. For real. Back in the day, nigga, you talk about paper with goddamn, you sweating on the stage. Goddamn lowdown.
So it's a real heavy.
But y'all smart enough not to do no dumb shit. Man, nigga take it. You know it's going to go down like that. But why these young niggas got to do stuff? You $1 million niggas now. You know, it's more $1 million niggas in Memphis.
And see, that's the thing.
You
feel me?
It's more, you know, everybody's got $250,000 down the middle.
See, that's the thing.
You know what I'm saying?
The bag is being handed out to these artists.
Yes.
And I think now, you know, it's a lot of, you know, and shout out to LGBT, all the what's that. I don't have anything to do with anybody, you know, on that platform. You know what I'm saying? But I think now, like, a lot of artists now, they need, like, publicists. They need that. Like, they need somebody that's going to coach him. But like, look, you can't say this. You can't say that. You can't do this. You know what I mean?
And I think that's, like, I ain't going to keep it real.
I mean, listen, man. Okay. I mean, trying to keep it real. Get you canceled.
Yeah, man.
You see what I'm saying? And I don't think that takes away from them. You get somebody to kind of counsel you.
And
to kind of show you what you need to do.
Kind of buffer that out a little bit. I agree with you. I just think.
And he's young, too.
Yeah.
The baby young.
Yeah, all them guys under 30, most of them under 25. That's almost a baby, man.
Yeah.
To your point, man, you know, I think. Yeah, publicists and just coaching and but I rock with the young people and it's because, you know, like I said, I grew up with my son. He, you know, I was one of them older dudes. And I'm like, man, I'm still, you know, that's why I was so hyped when that versus I woke everybody up in the house with that versus of Jada Kiss and I was excited about that. Like I was thinking about that when I seen it.
Right.
When they said August 2nd, I was like, hey, on my watch. I wouldn't miss it for the world. Like that's kinda like my errand shit. I knew that was both sides or whatever, you know what I mean? I didn't know it was going to be whopsided like that, but...
I kind of did, but I didn't, though.
The whole Dipset with him.
Let me interrupt you, though. Because even if they had them, though...
Yeah.
Do
you think that was a good matchup? Let's start there first.
I think it was a great matchup. Here's what I think happened. And I heard that argument with Jay, but that was the songs that they were on. All they've been up at doing was kind of rapping, boring people. Them niggas hard, but the songs they were on wasn't the songs that would have made a difference, right?
Nah.
The only thing that made a difference in that verse to me, in my opinion, was the song placement and the DJ and how the song sounded. The other shit. Dipset shit didn't sound like the Lock shit. The Lock shit was clearer, louder, crisp. The DJ was on it. And you know that DJ just to know how. I'm an artist. I'm like, damn, they got it going on.
Right.
That shit was ticking like they prepared.
Like you said, practice.
That's the only thing was different.
Okay.
It was a good matchup. If Cam them had a good DJ that was on it, song placement and their music wasn't muffling sounding. Like I knew that from when they was mixing at the beginning when the other DJ was on it, and that other DJ came, even though the other DJ was playing bullshit, it still was low. It was almost like they didn't have their shit
together.
I don't know what that is, right? But their shit wasn't hitting the same.
It wasn't hitting.
So even when they play their hardest shit, the crowd had to kind of hear it and get up to it. It didn't hit like it's supposed to hit. They had some shit that's supposed to hit way harder than they didn't. You know what I'm saying? Because I'm a performer. I know. Like, damn. Or when the DJ don't drop it on the same cue. It was the only mishap I had with Elroy is my DJ dropped something too early or too late or the wrong one, the wrong version of one.
Yeah.
Trap Talk. And I was like, that was a big, when we talked about the conclusion, I was like, we just messed up one thing. But that small thing, so just think of your DJ was doing that the whole time.
Right,
you know what I'm saying?
Right.
It was like, he dropped something. I was like, come on. And it was kind of, it's supposed to hit how you performed it. So Trap, you know, one time I was like, switching up my holes or whatever, and he kind of was late and did the wrong one. It didn't hit the same, it didn't have the same effect that it would have had if he was on it. You know what I'm saying?
I'm telling you, they had some shit.
Okay. Dipset had some shit. They just wasn't on it.
So do you think that affected them as far as them actually?
Yeah.
Because for me, it showed that Styles, Sheek, and Jada.
No, bro.
They was used to performing, and they had been doing it.
They was used to performing.
See, they practiced.
Man, them niggas, they was on it.
That's what I'm saying. But to me, it didn't look like Dipset.
To your point, them niggas just was, man, I had shows like that. When I look at YouTube sometimes, my shows, I cringe sometimes.
Yeah.
I'm like, man, we just can't bullet, man. That's what that was.
Yeah.
I'm looking at me.
Yeah.
I'm looking at me up there. The crowd, and we had 1,000 people and all that, but I went back to tell somebody if I really took the performance part of the rap series, I didn't. Not coming to every show, I'm bullet, I got gas, I'm thinking about whatever we got 100 niggas. That's how that looked.
Yeah.
That was me, so I'm not knocking them. I fuck with them.
Yeah.
And I'm not sure if they would have
fucked with them.
But it would have been way closer.
It'd be closer,
It would have been way closer.
Okay.
I was looking at me up there. It was bullshit.
That was bullshit. That was bullshit.
Yeah, I got a beast chair and everything.
Yeah, man.
I was shocked too because I was just
saying
people at the barber shop.
I said dip.
For the simple fact, because they had more radio jams than the lock. For you to be to know a lot of the lock shit, you have to be really fans of them. It's a lot more people that knows Dipset shit than they know the locks. Like, I knew everything the locks put on.
Because bro, I was referring.
You see what I'm saying?
Bro, I woke my baby up. My lady, like I said, all they look young. She knew some of them or whatever. Yeah. Like, that was a record. But, man, listen.
Yeah.
Them niggas was up there spitting that shit.
Oh, they were
cold-blooded, man.
They were.
Listen, man. Even, like, everybody was
with no words on the beat.
DJ Tech. Listen, the motherfucker was hitting that shit. Boom, 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 and it was going to the third person. It was going, like, it was some shit going on, man. Right, it was crazy. That was only crazy. A DJ or music people really knew. Now, everybody appreciated it, but real music people was like, me and Lito talk. Me and Lito talk 3 hours, man.
Yeah.
And Lito music, man, we was like, nah, that was different.
Yeah.
It was.
That was different.
Me and Lito talk
3 hours. Me and Pistol talk 3 hours the next day. I was talking to real music people. They was like, nah, that was different.
That was different.
So a music rap person, and you'll see yourself in the other one. I knew the other person, that was me.
Yeah.
Man, them dudes didn't know. Listen, it was times they didn't know their words.
They did.
DJ, man, it was times so bad that the DJ played late. They didn't know they were all of this in
they
one
look
song.
Tired.
All, okay. Yep. So you look tired. DJ came late.
Yeah.
You don't know your words all in one record. Yeah. You know how much that deflates
it
the
did.
Crowd?
It did.
And it happened probably it 6 or 7
it
times.
It did. And that's why Jada was shouting that out like that.
Yeah.
This is New York, man. Y'all be tired. Yeah.
That happened 6 or 7 times. I seen it.
I'm bringing Max B out.
No. So you don't know your words. Yeah. DJ hit it late. You tired. And your music low. So when you try to hit the big man, the motherfucker come with low velocity. It's down.
Yeah.
So you do all that in one, it'll make you have a landslide a lot.
Because when Jada came with that Notorious at Freestyle.
Man, that shit was hitting that shit sound, the clarity of that shit. Yeah.
Like he just performed it yesterday.
Yeah, man.
It did.
And them niggas was going. Them niggas was ad-libbing. Okay, so one nigga rapping and it's two niggas. Let me show y'all some rap shit. Yeah. It's one nigga rapping, but two niggas ad-libbing. Now, ain't no ad-libs, so y'all not ad-libbing on the real original record.
Right, exactly.
Because you're not ad-libbing on each other's songs.
Exactly.
You know, so
exactly.
Jada gets ad-lib his own stuff. So not only they made up new ad-libs, right? I'm rapping, y'all two got new ad-libs on in sequence on every song. So whoever was rapping, the other two had the same ad-lib together, right? And it was new.
Yeah.
So it wasn't like, we saying your ad-lib from this record. Yeah. No, they made up their own
They was the embodiment of a fine-tuned old machine.
That's why I said, because I was looking at it like his two, he rapping. What's my song, man? 24 hours. The boy rapping his verse, the whole verse.
Right.
What's like Jada and Cameron just cheek on it.
Yeah.
You know, he rapping his verse, but Jada know his verse.
Right.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So, like, dude, y'all.
And I seen them have
that
a
nigga
whole new
song.
They shot, man.
They had a whole new hook to one of them songs in the whole. They were like, something. And I said, what is going on?
Mm-hmm.
They just got a whole new hook to a song.
Right.
They did the verse. So that's why they were saying they were lip syncing, because they was making almost whole new hooks and singing what they want to sing, but it was in sequence and it was on beat and it was in a collective manner. You know what I'm saying? It was like, what is going on? This ain't the fucking show.
I was
looking on the show, and if y'all say this and you and but it was, I was like, damn, the motherfucker. And when I looked at the after things and all that shit the next day, I was mesmerized, but I still been watching the interviews and what they say and stuff like that. You know what I'm into that.
I said,
like,
on a break.
And they said she was on one of them the next morning, and he would say, like, we practice every day, you know what I'm saying, since we knew. They said they practice every day, 8 hours since they knew. And
that's taking it serious.
That's
MC.
I
got to coach up, man. I'm not going to come out here sloppy.
I'm not
coming out here sloppy, man.
That's definitely wasn't on their game, man.
Then they said Cameron was
he about to leave
and stuff, and he was, cause I
folks can come in.
Yeah, in the beginning, it wasn't right. He came in out. He just wasn't right.
Because I think everybody that was on the stage was mostly Dipset people.
Yeah.
Like, only came, they didn't come. They didn't come with a lot of folks.
They came to rap.
Yeah.
The niggas came to rap, man.
Yeah, niggas just standing on stage just trying to look cool.
Yeah, look.
I know paper, baby. And then
you have to to me, it looked real like 2004-ish to me.
It was. Yeah.
Like, it didn't matter. I don't know nothing a whole lot about it.
Everybody got a whole lot of chairs.
It just was real.
And honestly, I think they realized that when they was on stage.
Yeah.
They knew that.
They knew the feel. They picked up. It was like this coordination, and they piggybacked off that, and they knew that y'all tried to come out here and because they know Locks ain't really no big dressers, and they're like, and it's gonna backfire.
It did backfire.
You know what I'm saying? I understand them saying with the drip because it's Harlem.
But they wasn't even dripping right. Everything just looked right. I seen a man, man.
They said he looked like, they said he had about four or five different designers on. This nigga had Louis Gucci.
And then they said the man where they said he would hold his teeth in or something. I was crazy. Because it did look like something was up with his fronts or something. Yeah. I remember when he got out, he had no fronts. Jim Jones fell off stage, which he was tripping.
Which he said the reason why it looked like he fell off stage, he said he saw his ring fly.
And he said,
you know what? That had to have been 100,000 plus.
Jim Jones actually did the best out of everybody.
Okay.
He tried to carry him. He was more reserved. He wasn't Cameron. Everybody tried to say he dropped the ball. He wasn't right.
Yeah.
And Joel Santana was bullshit.
It's bullshit,
all day long. Every day. I see that shit. I'm like, nah, cut that shit out. But right here, right now, man, this is episode 25, man, season 3, man, all about the paper part 2, man. Where can catch you at, paper, man?
Yeah.
You can just catch me. I'm still on the IG. I'm regular on there. Marcus Fitzgerald _senior. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Because my son got the same Marcus Junior.
Yeah.
And then on Facebook, I'm just Marcus Fitzgerald. So I'm just a regular dude, man. I'm just old, you know what I'm saying?
You can touch this, man. I call.
Just hand me up, man. If I ain't doing shit, I'm just regular, man. I'm just trying to go to a basketball game and go to a bar or something. I ain't tripping on that.
Man, congratulations on your engagement, man. I wish you and the new wife well.
Yeah, I love her.
And your baby, man.
See, that's what I'm talking about. They say he love her.
Oh, I love her.
I love the promo. I can tell you, the promo you did, I said, ooh, he's...
For real, though. We shake it. It's some real grown man shit. We trying to switch up, you know, you can be with your gal and stuff like that, and it actually keep you safe. But you gotta get somebody you can rock with. Y'all kind of share the same stuff. You know what I mean? Same type of hobbies and shit like that.
She don't go for the bullshit.
She's trying to go too.
Already.
She's zero.
TTG.
Yeah. She got that in.
Paper, one of them shirts, man. I need a 3X.
Yeah, 3X. Okay, yeah.
You know what I'm saying? This is a 4. Like, you put a 2 on me, man. That nigga got titties.
And I was on the website ordering for the order 2, blue and a black.
Yeah.
My car got hacked. They done shut me. Yeah, they shut my shit down. I hit K up, man.
When you hit me, I hit miles.
We gonna wear them on the show. We gonna get some man. Man, we got years of that shit. So I let y'all know when we read. Yeah. We gonna have some more shit on there.
Yeah.
They ain't letting sell this. So it's still the NAI, TSU.
Okay.
Still got they own their stuff.
Okay.
So we kind of learning as new. You know what I'm saying? But we can create something new. So that's why we created the one. So we have the one jersey kind of like this with the Tennessee
with
state.
Okay.
But you can't sell, you can wear stuff, so we got this stuff made, but you can't sell it on his website, anything to say Tennessee State. So
that's understandable.
License and shit like that.
That's what's up, man.
Man, well, thank you for coming. coming through, man.
Yeah, man.
Real, job, man. Real way, man. Blessing us, bro. Shout out to Low Visions, man. Shout out to DJ motherfucking Duff.
DJ Duff.
City, man.
Yeah.
He's going down in the real way. He going hard, man. It's Virgo season, man. You got Thrill on, man. You know what I'm saying? Michael Jackson right now,
that's right.
And we taking the month off. You know what I'm saying? Me and my Virgo, we taking the month off,
yeah, man.
Man. Fort Lauderdale sipping on something good.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Smoking on some good wood.
That's right.
You know what I'm talking about, man. We catch y'all in October.
That's tough.
Episode 26, man. With my boys, PJ and Yeah, man. We be out here in Bellevue, man. Mm-hmm. And we gonna go do it like this. Peace.
Yeah.
Love. Church.
Yes, sir.